Hello, space cats, and welcome back to my channel. I want to introduce you to the Flat Earth Society. Their Twitter page boasts over 85,000 followers, which means at least 85,000 people believe that the Earth is really flat. But is it really? And if it's not flat, then why do so many people think it is? In this week's video, I'm going to be explaining all of this and more. Favoured flat earth theory is that the earth is a disk surrounded by an ice wall. Their main reasoning being that the earth looks flat and the bottom of clouds are flat too. Even though the members of the Flat Earth Society generally believe in scientific evidence, they also have a huge grudge against us scientists. They often carry out their own scientific experiments to try and help prove their point. However, a lot of the times they fail, including the daredevil Mike Hughes, who has had several attempts of using homemade rockets to blast himself into space in attempts to see the curvature of the Earth for himself. The Flat Earth Convention, which attracts hundreds of people every year, is a place for like-minded people to discuss what they think the real shape of the Earth is and why they believe it's covered up. These conspiracy theorists are also the typical type that don't believe in gravity or the moon landings. Several celebrities have also been vocal about being flat earthers, including the singer B.O.B. and the former England cricketer Freddie Flintoff. Hundreds of people have been into space. They've seen the curvature of the Earth with their own eyes, and not one of them has announced that the Earth is flat. You would have thought if it were true, at least one of them would have cracked by now. But according to flat earthers, this is because the space agencies of the world are involved in a conspiracy faking space travel and exploration that started back during the space races of the Cold War. But if that were the case, then how do we explain things like this, and this, and this? Well, photographic evidence can easily be altered, and apparently all camera lenses have some inherent lens curvature. On the Flat Earth Society page, they provide several evidences of flat Earth. So let's debunk them. Firstly, there's an explanation of how the day and night cycle would work for a flat Earth. Except, we know that the sun is spherical, so why would it radiate like an ellipse? Secondly, for a flat earth theory to work, you require a magnetic monopole, and they explain this away with radial magnets. However, radial magnets have to have a large enough inner diameter to be stable, which would mean that as you approach the North Pole, all of a sudden your compass would start to point south instead of north, which does not happen. We also know that the planets and the sun are round, so the flat earthers say that Earth can still be flat because the planets orbit around the Earth. If this were the case, however, there would be no simple way to explain away the movements of planets on the sky. According to flat earthers, gravity does not pull the Earth into a sphere because gravity is much weaker than we're taught. What's really happening is dark energy is accelerating the Earth upwards at the same rate as gravity. And whilst this conforms with Einstein's equivalence principle, there is no reason why this acceleration would be perfectly perpendicular to the plane of the flat Earth. We know that the Earth is round, and there's plenty of scientific evidence to support this. In ancient Greek history, dating back as early as 500 BC, there were two main theories for the shape of the world. Homer advocated that the Earth was a flat disk, and Pythagoras believed that the Earth was spherical, since that was the most perfect shape. The latter was more favoured by the ancient Greeks, and the two early arguments for this were that firstly, the eclipses of the moon's shadow were circular shadows, and secondly, Polaris, the North Star, is always seen lower in the horizon the more south you walk, which is really hard to explain with a flat Earth. At around 300 BC, Eratosthenes measured the circumference of the Earth. He knew that on the day of the summer solstice, at exactly midday, that the sun would be directly overhead in the city of Syene. It would not cast a shadow. He also knew that the city of Alexandria, which was directly north of Syene and separated by a distance of 800 kilometers, that the sun in Alexandria at midday on summer solstice was not directly overhead. By measuring the angle of the sun in Alexandria from the zenith point, the point directly overhead, Eratosthenes was able to calculate the circumference of the Earth using knowledge about spheres. The angle that he measured was 7 degrees, or about 1/50th of a circle. This corresponds to 800 kilometers. So for a full circle, we do 50 times 800, which is about 40,000 kilometers. Today, we know that the Earth's circumference is 40,075 kilometers. He was incredibly close. Another easy way that we can prove the Earth is spherical is to use our knowledge of triangles on surfaces with different curvatures. If the Earth is flat, then it has zero curvature. That means if you draw an equilateral triangle, over large distances, the sum of the angles of the triangle will be 180 degrees. If the Earth has positive curvature, like a sphere does, then if you draw an equilateral triangle on it, you'll see that the angles of the triangle sum to larger than 180 degrees. And if you have an Earth who has negative curvature, for example, it might be saddle-shaped, then the angles will sum to less than 180 degrees. To test this, you could walk or fly a few hundred kilometers, turn 60 degrees, travel the same distance, turn 60 degrees again, travel the same distance again, and you'll find that you won't end up in the place that you started out at. This is because the Earth is spherical. To be honest, I still have no idea why some people can genuinely believe that the Earth is flat. Given all the evidence, however, I hope I've managed to convince you that it's not. Or even better, if you weren't a flat earther to begin with, I hope you enjoyed this video. As usual, if you enjoyed the video, please, it would mean so much to me if you could leave me a like, share, and subscribe.